Sama dengan Indonesia, Eropa juga terkenal dengan kekayaan budayanya. Setiap negara punya ciri khas dan keunikan masing-masing. Yuk dengar cerita langsung dari Bapak dan Ibu Dubes. Apa saja ya yang menjadi ciri khas negaranya?
Well, in terms of culture, you know, actually Croatia, I would say, is a very, very, how to put it, historical country. We had back in the history many inventors. Actually, talking about the tie, about the necktie, this is invention of Croatians. And in culture, we had in the past, you know, many composers, many writers, many worldwide known artists.
Well, I think one of our assets is we have such a diverse and a historical range of culture. So it depends, again, what you like. We have one of the world's biggest music festivals in Glastonbury in June. If you like all kinds of music, we have the world's biggest arts festival in Edinburgh in August. And then we have plenty of other niche cultural activities. If you like literature, you can go and visit Jane Austen's, the sites of Jane Austen's novels. So it really depends what you like. There's hundreds of museums to visit, whether that's in London or other cities around the country.
Oh, well, it's what Spain is known for. I would say for her literature, for her paintings, for her history. If you have painters like Velázquez, like Picasso, like Dali, or you know, you have left, or Miró, you have left a footprint in the history of art. And the same for literature. Our literature is worldwide known. All in all, what I used to say is that we really built a civilization.
Wah, menarik sekali. Nah, Bapak dan Ibu Dubes punya bocoran nggak buat kita-kita tentang museum yang bagus, konser atau festival yang seru di sana?
Traditional museums, like all around the world, what you see, you go inside and you see good pieces of art. And there are some unusual museums. We have one very, very unusual museum in the capital city of Zagreb, which is called Museum of Broken Relationships. So basically, what can you find there? You can find different things that, you know, some couples who broke up, they donated to the museum as a remembrance of their relationship earlier. Croatia is very, very rich in tradition and history. Basically, in small Croatia, you would find 7 historical and cultural sites that are UNESCO sites. So it's really rich culture in Croatia.
For me, I like in London going to the theatre in the South Bank, to the National Theatre there, seeing both serious theatre inside, but also the street theatre on the South Bank itself, going out to eat in the evening at the restaurants there and enjoying that lifestyle, especially in the summer months.
Let's see, in Madrid, we're talking about Madrid because there are many others around Spain. In Madrid, you have the National Library, which is really one of the most important cultural places in the world. And it is open to the public, and you can have access to very important and unique documents. The building is in itself a historic and architectural monument in the center of Madrid. I would recommend also, of course, the main museums. We have 3 of the major museums of the world in the space of 1 mile, which is the Prado Museum, the Reina Sofia Museum, and the Thyssen Gallery. All 3 very, you can walk from one to the other. And so those are probably the places I would recommend above all.
Hello, I'm Olaf Skoog. I'm the EU ambassador to Indonesia. Indonesia is really a fantastic country. So many places to visit and so much to see. But don't forget, there is a world outside of Indonesia too. And I strongly recommend that you visit Europe. You can get on the plane in the evening and you can wake up in one of the fantastic capitals of Europe in the morning. And you know, it's like visiting a big amusement park. You enter at one entry point and you can enjoy all the attractions within that continent of Europe. So why wait? Come along with your family and friends to discover Europe at Destination Europe.